My name is Greg Stehouwer. Been here since 2010. It's been 11 years now. I've been a trainer for almost 9 years. Some of the things I look at is I've got a million miles safe driving now plus. Never had a load shift. That's really important to me. Obviously no accidents. Some of the things I try to teach my trainees is to, number one, always observe your on and off ramps, watch for traffic that's getting off as well as getting on, that tells you how much room you need to make, to allow traffic to merge, gives you time to actually figure out if you need to change a lane, whether that's in your best interest or not. Always triple check your mirrors, turn your turn signal on way in advance if you're gonna make a change like that. That way you can kind of keep track of where vehicles are. Try to get yourself in a habit of learning the makes, the models, the colors of the cars so you know where they went. If they don't know where they went, then you really need to double check the mirrors, make sure they're not along the right side of that hood. It's a pretty bad blind spot. Some of the basics on the driving: watch your speed, don't tailgate, wear your seatbelt. Things that they're gonna be looking for, especially in school zones. That'll impact your safety score as well as everything else just by not paying attention to those simple things. Load securement, that's one thing I've never had is a load shift. I trust TMC's policies as to why we secure the way we do. It's a tried and proven method. If you don't know what you're doing, call safety, call your trainer, call another driver, talk to a safety support team. Make sure when you're getting up and down on the trailer off the catwalk to always use 3 points of contact. Years ago, I didn't do that. I rolled an ankle. Luckily, didn't end up being too serious, but it did hurt me for a few weeks. It's not worth it. Just 3 points of contact. Don't jump off the trailers. That's actually real hard on your knees, your ankles, and your back. Could actually shorten your time with TMC from doing that due to your injuries. Make sure you're getting plenty of fluids, water mainly. Coffee and soda don't actually help you much when it's hot. You actually get dehydrated quicker by drinking those. So make sure you drink plenty of water. Proper PPE, very important. A lot of companies want you to wear the right stuff. Long sleeve shirts, jeans, steel-toed boots. A hard hat, safety vest, it's kind of important. Sometimes your clothing can help you from getting some of those cuts or scrapes that you might get, which could stop a workman's comp claim just by having the right attire. It's also company policy, so it isn't too hard to stay to that. Remember, we're all here to help. So just, if you don't know, just ask. None of us are just going to push you away. We want to help. That's what we're here for.